Welcome everybody. Welcome back to the channel. In this video, this week, we're gonna talk exclusively about how you can get started in real estate, how you can invest in real estate, what simple steps you can do to start today to get involved with real estate. Because it's very important to understand there's a process to every plan that you're trying to implement in real estate. If you stick around to the end of the video, I'm gonna share one bonus tip with you on what we do each and every day to help us grow in real estate. So, if you don't know, my name is Keontae. I'm your local real estate redeveloper in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, and I'm looking to give you exclusive real estate content based on my journey and ways to help you get started with real estate today. So, we're gonna get right to it. Please like, comment, or subscribe to my YouTube channel for more exclusive news on how you can get involved in real estate, business opportunities, and also discuss financial-related opportunities as well. Number one, simple, start with your why. No matter what you're doing, you need a strong foundation. Understanding your why allows you to figure out deep down inside what drives you, what motivates you, and what's going to continue to push you to exceed those goals that you may set when you get to phase number two in regard to developing your plan. Because having a strong why allows you to dictate what level and how much you care about what you're doing, which drives you to point number three, developing a strong awareness of how to utilize your time. Keyword, time. Time in real estate goes hand in hand. Real estate takes time to build wealth, so therefore it's understanding of how to utilize your time. Figure out ways you want to invest in real estate, because it's going to be vital in order for you to figure out how much time you want to invest long term. Which brings us to number four, right? Understanding what your credit score is and how to leverage it. Do you need credit to get involved in real estate? The answer is no, you don't. When I started in real estate 4 years ago, my credit score was below a 500. Yes, below a 500. So I'm someone like you that started without a high credit score above 700 to 800. No, you do not need that to get involved with real estate. Now, is it great to have it? Yes, but it's a very important factor to use for people that are looking to scale largely, because a good credit allows you to leverage large amounts of money. Number five, my favorite, right? Finance. Know your finances. Know your budget, weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly. Does not matter. Know your numbers. When real estate is all a numbers game in the beginning. But truly, is it really? It's understanding how to leverage your finances to be involved with real estate and to remain consistently involved with real estate. Two different things, because anybody can invest $100 and start in real estate today, or you can invest no money and start in real estate. But if you wanna do this long term, it's understanding your finance is gonna be vital, because you're gonna have to manage some long term. So it's very important to understand that, right? Number six is one of the best things I can share with you, honestly. Figuring out what path you want to go investing in real estate. I want to be specifically focused in residential, but that does not have to be your path. There are a plethora of options what you can get involved with, whether it's residential, single family properties, multifamily properties. I want to just own condos, townhouses, land, mobile homes. It does not matter, but it's essential for you to understand what you're trying to do, because it's gonna dictate how you're gonna fit the five previous steps we talked about moving forward long term. So if you stay to the end of the video, I would like to say thank you, appreciate your time and an understanding of how we're trying to start this thing off right with real estate, because it's very essential. Now, the bonus for this week. The bonus word for this week is books. Books allows you to build your intelligence on what you're trying to utilize and also spread to others. And so one thing that is going to be essential for you on your real estate career is to remember reading books to understand where people have come from and how you can transition those lessons learned to opportunities for you to grow in real estate. So the books I've read across my journey will be listed in the description below that have helped me to shape my mindset my why, my core values, because it's very essential to know what, where, and how you're getting involved with real estate, because this is a long-term business. So if you like this type of content, please like, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more exclusive real estate, finance, or business-related content. Reach out to us on all social media platforms. Thank you.